When I ordered my new car 5 months ago, the dealer didn't have an SE in stock, so this is the interior of the SE. As you can see, it doesn't have the wood grain, but it has the black piano finish. I quite like it. I wasn't interested in sunroofs and electric tar gates because I use my tar gate many times a day, and I was just pleased the way it turned out. The steering wheel looks very similar to most Range Rovers I've seen, and I also optioned the heated front seats as I find leather quite cold in winter. I decided to start doing this video when I was looking around for information. There was very little information around the actual owners of the car. There's a very good one from the US called Earth Rover, but each country has so much difference in their features and options and model range. For example, the SE in the US gets the 10-inch screen and Australia gets the 8-inch screen, things like that. And obviously certain countries suit certain configurations, as in you can only buy diesel in Australia. That's because our gasoline or petrol prices are so expensive, and also there'd be more chance of off-roading and caravan towing in Australia. So I'm just going to drive around and point out some of the features that the car has. Okay, I thought I'd show you the outside of the car's optional features. On the top is the full-length roof rack, the privacy glass and the 20-inch wheels. At the back of the car, I had the signature tail lights, which these tail lights stay on all day. And in Australia, you get the standard tow bar. An interesting thing is that the bonnet release is on the left-hand side. Quite easy in operation. That's the V6, 190 kilowatts. Interesting thing is you can't see the battery. This is the jump start points. This is your negative and that's your positive. And has quite a large amount of space between the front of the car and the front of the engine, and you can see there's a massive steering box down there. I think it's an electric steering, but overall the car's padded under the bonnet really nicely and very well finished. I did find these IR codes a little bit unreliable, I guess you'd call it, but overall the engine's amazing. Now let's have a look into the car, and the navigation is still quite good. As you can see my location, I'm in a new estate, so it's not showing up yet, but I do find it working well. The air conditioner works very well. I have the all-terrain response too. This gives you two electronic locking diffs and like off-road cruise control. I'm looking forward to my Land Rover experience today because it will teach me how to use all the apparatus. As you can see, I've done 1,773 k's and I've averaged 8.6 litres per 100 kilometres, which I think is amazing. Sure to put press under the V, put your wrist in the D, and I check the side mirrors to see whether they're moving to be sure, and in you go. I thought I'd do a review on a five-seater Discovery like mine. Most of the ones I've seen have been all the seven-seaters. So I thought it has a lot of extra space in storage underneath, and I don't have electronic folding seats, so I'll just give you an idea of how it all works. First of all, you've got a little button on the left hand side of the headrest, go down. One part that you expect to work is this little lever up here, but that doesn't operate the seat. A lever down below operates on the swab here. Little swab just here. And as you can see, it has a large amount of space, the same as the seven-seater. This is a factory-fitted mat. As you can see, there's a ridge in the middle. I don't know, I was hoping that would flatten out as it got older. But it's about 5-6 weeks old now. In the back here, you have your storage room. A little hook to hold it up. And in here I have a recovery kit. Actually a 20-litre collapsible bucket, a sunshade, and a little tarp so I can use it if I need to get down dirty under the car or something. In here was a foam object. I don't really know what it's for. And I've heard other people have taken that out, so I've taken that out and I've just put cleaning rags, spare fins from a board, and chamois and that sort of thing. The car has LED lights here, here and here and here, and the SE doesn't get the USBs in the little side pockets up here. It has the air suspension so you can lower it from here to assist your loading. It has the hooks, but overall I find that extra storage space fantastic. It's a shame that the extra seats take up so much space, I think. I hope this video has been helpful for people who are thinking of buying a Discovery or people who are just curious to know a bit more about them. I hope to have a few more videos in the future. Once I get own it for a few more thousand Ks, I'll do a review of what I like and what I dislike about it. I don't think there's obviously a lot more likes than dislikes at this time. But if you enjoy the video, make a comment, because the more comments I get, the better I can do the next one. So thanks for watching, and if you like, have a look at some of my other videos and subscribe if you wish to. Thank you.